टोरिक आवल प्रैक्टिकल गाइड फॉर नोविस आई सर्जन बाय डॉक्टर मुकेश झुलकिया, महुआ, गुजरात, इंडिया। दिस वीडियो इज इंटेंडेड टू गाइड टू ऑल ऑप्थेमोलॉजिस्ट हु आर कीन टू स्टार्ट टोरिक आवल प्रैक्टिस। इट इज मेंट फॉर एजुकेशन पर्पज ओनली। यू नीड टू कॉन्टेक्ट एजुकेशनली क्वालिफाइड एक्सपर्ट फॉर मोर इन्फॉर्मेशन। हियर यू कैन रीच टू मी। I have no financial interest. In this video, we will discuss following topics. 1. Patient selection criteria. 2. All power calculation, lens selection and various formulas. 3. Pre-operative corneal marking of 0 and 180 degree. 4. Technique of intraoperative IOL placement. 5. Post-operative IOL position confirmation. And 6. If needed, post-operative IOL rotation. Number 1. Select a case of astigmatism more than 1D against the rule and for more than 1.5D in case of with the rule. Criteria 2. Select a case of pure corneal astigmatism. For that, take the consideration of K1 and K2 only. If you have facility of topography, you can use it. Number 3. Exclude any case where corneal astigmatism and patient refractions do not match. 4th, select a case of virgin cornea only. Any surgery done on cornea like RK, pterygium surgery, LASIK, LASIK, etc. should be dealt cautiously or better avoided. 5th, better not to assure the patient 00 on either autorefractometer or at refraction. It is rarely possible even in the best of best institute. Only assure about reduction in cylindrical power. Any patient who is not ready to accept this truth, better to avoid him. We have various formulas to calculate the IOL power, but in my hand, and of course many experienced surgeons too, believe that Barrett's online toric calculator works best in most cases. This is how Barrett's online toric calculator looks like. WS Wewicker and Sorup toric tool is offline tool with many added features. And this is what WS tools looks like. General rule is like follow. For with the rule astigmatism, deduct half diopter, half diopter from delta K, whatever number comes, add 1/3 to that number, and that is the power you need for toric IOL. Example: K1 is 44 at 180 and K2 is 46 at 90. This is with the rule. Delta K is 2. Deduct half from this. It is 1.5D. Add 1/3 to it. It is 0.5. So after addition it comes 2.00. So IOL toricity you need for that particular patient is 2 diopter. For against the rule astigmatism, add half D to delta K, whatever number comes, add 1/3 of that number, and that is the power you need for toric IOL. Here, K1 is 44 at 90 and K2 is 46 at 180 degree. Against the rule astigmatism, delta K is 2. Add half D from this, it is 2.5D. Add 1/3 to it comes 0.83. So after addition it comes 3.33. So IOL toricity you need for that particular patient is 3.33 diopter. Choose the nearest available power of 3.33. that is your toric IOL. For oblique astigmatism, do nothing to delta K. Add 1/3 of that number, and that is power you need for toric IOL. This is example. K1 is 44 at 45 degree and K2 is 46 at 135 degree. Delta K is 2. Do nothing and add 1/3 to it. So it comes around 2.757D. For K1 and K2, 44 and 46, everything is same, but the type of astigmatism changes its position and IOL needed also changes. that is due to posterior corneal power. Once patient is selected for toric IOL and calculation is done, IOL should be selected so that smallest number of cylinder power remains after surgery. Nowadays, we have vast choice of IOLs. Select according to patient's availability and surgeon's choice and experience. Number 3. Corneal marking of 0 and 180 degree. I am using pendulum marker, and then we have so many different mobile apps to confirm this marking position. Each app describes how to use them. One can use freehand marking and use this app also. In this video, patient is for 0 to 180 degree preoperative marking. Patient is instructed to the light which comes from behind the surgeon. Pendulum marker is used. 0 and 180 degree is marked. Once the marking is done, if the mark is little fed, then we can enhance with the help of marker pen. So the marking is done and it is little confirmed whether it is 0 at 0 and 180 or not. For that we will see close-up look. We have many mobile apps. I am using three different apps. One, Dr. Dholakia's and Dr. Jethwa's app. Two, Dr. Parth Mehta's Crystal Toric app. And third, Saurabh Patwardhan's iToric app. And this picture shows three different apps how it looks like. And this picture shows Crystal Toric and iToric app. Technique of intraoperative IOL placement. Here I do two-dimensional IOL alignment. In this technique, one has to close his non-dominant eye and to see through the dominant eye to align all Purkinje images, and at that particular point IOL markings are aligned with the corneal markings and final position of IOL is achieved. Here 3 degree is located. IOL is aligned at 3 degree by 2 dimensional technique. My left eye is closed and my right eye is open. Postoperative IOL position confirmation. What I do is I take autoref picture in retroillumination mode, and with the help of previous three apps one can check the IOL position in the postoperatively. This is retroillumination picture of the patient's eye postoperative. Same app can detect exact IOL rotation if IOL.
Here one can see the IOL is set at 183, in another app is at 3 degrees.
In this patient, IOL is rotated almost by 30 degrees from its intended axis. If needed, postoperative IOL rotation is done. This is done almost 1 week to 10 days later so that some amount of capsular fibrosis sets in and IOL stays at its position after rotation. Here, postoperatively, I take the patient after 10 days. Bimanual irrigation aspiration cannulas are inserted. With the help of irrigation cannula, I am separating the anterior capsule adhesion. Little bit adhesion are there. Once the adhesion are little free, I am trying to rotate the IOL. IOL is getting now rotated. Once the IOL sets at 90 degree, again using two-dimensional technique, I am finishing the case. I will set at 90 degree. These are some examples of results. One can see very good results are achieved with this technique. Thank you. Thanks for watching.